you very much for accommodating us to that apron zones and Skype difficulties. We really appreciate the opportunity to share our current research project with you all. The research that we're going to briefly talk about today is a collaboration with Anthropology, the University of Auckland, and the Centre of Research. This is a data management project that really began in field research in archaeology. Had a number of research projects based in Australia, in Egypt, and in New Zealand. Institutions from all around the world, and we came across a problem repeatedly where we really needed to share data between different researchers, between graduate students who are working on projects, principal investigators, and we also had a number of disciplines to accommodate within these research projects. So these were all research projects that were founded in archaeology, but incorporated aspects of geology, geomorphology, geophysics, anthropology, indigenous studies, and so on. So we really needed a way to accommodate all of those different perspectives and at the same time be able to effectively share data in a fairly rapid way, just we do field work now, individual components of those research projects. So this brought us to developing a better way of doing that than what we had done previously, and this is where the ARCHI project was born. So it's the Archaeology E-Research Collaboration Initiative. And when we began this project, we had to deal of different issues. And the first issue that we came up against, and I think this is an issue that all archaeology E-Research projects run into, and that is one of semantics. And of course, this is something that is common to many different disciplines, and we have colleagues working on semantics. So we had to really sit down with groups of the different researchers, and in some cases, different stakeholders, to talk through some of those semantic issues of definitions in archaeology. And there's been a lot of research recently talking about some of these problems, and of course this goes back to historic differences between the different schools of thoughts within archaeology. So we had to overcome some of those issues, and to a degree those issues that we are still grappling with at the moment. We also had to think a lot about how we managed legacy data sets and how we shared those existing data sets, because while we had principal investigators who were working on multiple research projects, so in many ways data management schema were quite similar, or the workflow that was used in field to the lab setting was very similar. We had to try and account for changes in technology, whether it be innovations in instruments we were using, the software stacks we were using, and what have you. So it was really quite a challenge to try and incorporate those existing legacy data sets. We also needed to think very carefully about the way we were using geospatial information, which is a really large part of the work that we do in ARLE, in any setting. And part of that was thinking about migrating towards open source software, because not all of our colleagues or not all of the stakeholders with whom we work had access to proprietary software. While on campus at the university we might use Esri GIS, not everybody has access to that. So we had to start to think outside the box a little bit, and I know many other research projects are also working on this area. The other thing that we've began to think about, I'm going to hand over to Josh in a couple of seconds, he'll touch on briefly, is the way that we give our researchers access to data, but also thinking about broader access to data. And I know one of the major themes of this this conference, this research group, is to think of access to data, open access to data in particular. And it's something that we've really started to explore beyond an academic. So while we think about data access in terms of our immediate research team, students who might be involved in the sort of teaching and learning environment, we other groups, so it might be other non-academic stakeholders, so the Indigenous groups that we work with, Nembunas, all those sorts of groups. And part of our challenge, particularly working in New Zealand, is to think about how we do that in a way that is sensitive to a variety of different heritage values in the sectors, maybe in Indigenous spheres or in commercial spheres or in academic settings, and many of those cross over and flow between quite in quite general. I'm going to hand over to Josh now to talk a little bit about where we're at in terms of this project.
Hi everyone. So a bit of background. In New Zealand, been called ArcSight. This is run by a volunteer program, the New Zealand Archaeology Association, and it's legally recognised as the national database. So all new archaeological sites go through this system. That being said, it has a number of inherent errors that have been with it since the start. One of the main things, as Rebecca touched on, was a lack of semantic, a standardized data schema, so semantic issues. For example, when is a site a site? How do you define a site? There was one case where a row of post holes was discovered and every post hole was recorded as a new site. Whereas you might see in the image on the screen right now, we have an area of interest where we've got that big trench that might be recognized, or that whole landscape might be recognized as a site in itself. There was a lot of variability as to what was being recorded. Spatial data was, a lot of these sites were recorded prior to GPS, so spatial data was done on the old map systems. And then when they were integrated back, when they were transferred to digital systems, mainly in that we now had sites, just because of the drift in things, they were out at sea when they might have been a coastal site, or even up a mountain when it was next to it. And there was no real clear way on how this data was being managed. So tying in with those issues that Rebecca spoke about with our projects, we thought, how can we start to apply this on a national level? And in my last, I'll just quickly go over this. We've developed the ARCHI system. So with this, we're really focused on data standards and management. How can we integrate all of the different ways that we collect data and the types of data that we come across from all those different fields and bring them into a common system? And you can see there are a couple of different ways we do field recording. So with total stations, laser scanners, terrestrial laser scanners, and tablets, we're recording a lot of data very quickly, but we need to manage that in a very coherent way that can be compared between projects. Right now, a lot of my work is cleaning this data. We use individual ID numbers for every artifact, every site, and that means things have to link up together. And that, you know, we do our best to make sure there are no errors, but 5% of the time, 3% of the time, something slips through the cracks and they take some time to fix. And also recording metadata. So how was the data recorded and obtained? That's another big part of what we're working on. And designing a common schema that's comparable across data sets. So when is a site a site? How can we compare, say, a trench we dig in Egypt with one that we've dug in New Zealand? And that really comes down to a lot of flexibility within our system. And what we also have to bear in mind is who's going to be using this system. So it might be Indigenous groups, it could be the government, it could be the commercial sector, so property developers. So we have to consider a lot of these different fields that have different requirements out of the system that we might develop. It's not just us for our research interest, but it's also how do different people want to use this data, and how can we record it in such a way and integrate that data into a system that's flexible enough to suit all those needs? So that's kind of where we're at the moment, is considering these issues and how we can move forward with it. We've got some ideas in terms of relational databases and hierarchical schemas, but it's very much a work in progress that we hope to carry on with in the coming years. So. Thank you very much. That's it. We'll switch back so we can see you. We can answer any questions if you want to type them up.